It has bought them victories against other teams, but this composition in particular with the Demon Hunter and Death Knight appears to be the kryptonite that they just cannot overcome. We see him in Poike targeted down early on by Method Black, already flexing some confidence here early on.
Yeah, let's see what Changed My Mind will be able to get done in this matchup. In the past, like we've said, Method Black, they kind of have Changed My Mind in check throughout the entire game. It seems like Raikou, Swapsy, they're able to easily keep themselves alive with the amount of self-healing that they have. Really, what Changed My Mind needs is Deep and Dampening. Then they can push through some of those defensives, some of that self-healing Raikou and Swapsy have available. But at that point, Ninpoike is out of mana, and the consistent pressure from Raikou and Swapsy overwhelms them consistently every time. When Changed My Mind has had good pressure in this particular matchup, it was off the back of making consistent swaps over onto Chaz, trying to get cross-crowd control on Raikou and Swapsy to deny the anti-magic zone and the darkness that they can provide Chaz, that safety net. And if they can do that, they can take away that safety net from Raikou and Swapsy, then Chaz actually becomes a semi-vulnerable target.
Yep. Now just running through the potential win conditions for Change My Mind, they have three options because there's three targets on the opposing team. If they try and kill Chaz, it needs to just be all out aggression, all in, overwhelm him, hope that Method Black make a mistake and crack and they can take Chaz down. It's probably one of the most risky ones to pick in terms of strategy and definitely not super high percent to win. The other option is to try and get Raikou's Gladiator's Medallion with crowd control, make him use it aggressively. If he never does that, though, then he will not be open to a smoke bomb, which Acro is running, which makes me think he wants to do that strategy. Burst down Raikou, bait that Gladiator's Medallion, and then kill him in a smoke bomb. And then the other option and the third target is Swapsy. On that Unholy Death Knight, they're going to require 30-40% dampening and higher, I think, to kill Swapsy as the Rogue Mage composition. If they want to go for that strategy, Ninpoike has to find drinks, he needs to regenerate his mana, and he needs to prepare for a really long game against a composition that's completely designed to prevent that. So basically, every single target, they need a miracle to get a kill. It's not to say that it's not impossible, but it is highly unlikely. So far, they've set themselves up well for the first strategy, which is killing Chaz. They've gotten his Gladiator's Medallion out of the way. Acro is attacking Chaz a lot more. We do see Swapsy grip Acro away. Chaz now can get time to breathe. It's really important for Chaz to be 40 yards away. They see a swap opportunity onto Raikou as he overextended. They drop the smoke bomb. Raikou, disrespect, not even trading the Gladiator's Medallion on that. Able to sit through the sunlock comfortably. Netherwalk towards the end of it, and that, if you're Changed My Mind and you see that, Raikou just overextends, doesn't even use the Glider's Medallion to get out of the smoke bomb, I'd say that's the most likely win condition for Changed My Mind. What do you do at this point? I mean, you've got to just go all out. Mana at least looks decent. Perhaps that's their best route to victory, is trying to get a drink. Maybe Ninpoike should play a different healer and still just run the Rogue Mage, but play a Mistweaver. Then they can have mana deeper into dampening. Maybe a grapple weapon Rogue Mage and kill Swapsy and deny the Death Strike. I just don't think Minpoike's Druid is going to cut it if they want to stay with a Rogue Mage.
Yeah, Fat Kitty, the build he's playing is interesting. He's going for the Tunnel of Ice Lonely Winter build. So I think one of the reasons why Raikou can sit these smoke bomb stun locks is because the only significant damage Fat Kitty is going to be able to put out is if he is casting out the Frost Bolts, and he does combo that with the Flurry proc. If he gets that damage, that's going to be huge. But with the build he's playing, he doesn't have Comet Storm, he doesn't have Ice Nova, and that's where a lot of that one-shot burst comes from those smoke bomb attempts from Changed My Mind. And without that, Raikou knows he can get away with quite a bit of greed in this matchup, especially with Swapsy denying a lot of the cast of damage Fried Kitty has available. And Raikou, of course, he can always rely on that Gladiator Safeguard, which he's running as well. If he has that sort of cheap death proc from the trinket, then he's not going to be feeling too scared.
I think this is a criticism that we've given Ninpoike in the past, is that phenomenal druid, historic player, great performance. But when he needs to step off the druid, he either just doesn't do it and tries to rely on the druid when it's not advantageous, or can't perform at the same level as the other healers, diversifying onto a deeper roster. And that's the main weakness for Change My Mind. Phenomenal individual players on their classes. Easily, Fried Kitty, one of the best mages. Acro, one of the best rogues. Ninpoike, one of the best druids. And obviously, Valet, one of the best shadow priests. But if the meta isn't paying into their compositions, then they just can't beat the best teams that have diversified their roster. So moving forward in the tournament circuit, I really want to see Change My Mind bring more compositions, bring more healers onto their roster, because I actually think a Mistweaver Rogue Mage wouldn't even be that awful into Method Black, and that's only one player having to change their specialization.
Yeah. I don't know if I necessarily agree, just because I think it's difficult. I think one of the reasons Pinpoiki can ever get away is because he has stealth and because he has Shadow Meld. I guess a Mystery Weaver Monk could have Shadow Meld as well, but without this, the threat of this, like Pinpoiki right now, being in cat form, running away, this is the only time he really has to be able to escape and potentially look for a drink. On the Mystery Weaver Monk, he's never going to really have that luxury to sit down where he's completely invisible and buy himself enough time to get the drinks off that he needs, because I feel like they do need that reset on mana. Raikou getting bursted down with no blur, no iron bark. Could be an exposed target, but specking into the nether walk, that's going to allow him a major defensive he can rotate through in order to keep himself alive. Fried Kitty using a lot of damage there. That was actually the Icy Veins, and they didn't really net too much. They didn't get the big defensive cooldowns that they really needed. Just some of the shorter ones, like that iron bark and blur, which now are once again going to be almost available for Method Black.
All right, 6% dampening. Chaz under a bit of pressure from Acro, but Fried Kitty as well. Pinpoiki's done a phenomenal job to maintain his mana for that one potential win condition, killing Swapsy deeper into dampening. Pinpoiki is setting his team up for that option. How much longer can he keep it up in the face of Raikou gunning him down, start to finish with Mana Rift is really the question. Perhaps Change My Mind can do it. They've been a lot more aggressive. They've been getting good pressure out. Flyer's Medallion from Chaz forced frequently as they try to set up a swap to him once again, maybe pull an Iron Bark for an attempt later on. Smoke Bomb could be a kill window for Swapsy if they can get Icebound Fortitude prior to it. They drop the Smoke Bomb on Raikou. They get a Cyclone on Chaz. Setup looks good from Change My Mind. Fried Kitty gets stalled on the burst. Raikou exchanges the Nether Walk, which is more than an efficient trade for Smoke Bomb. He can then rely on Darkness for Vendetta or Blur for Vendetta, so he should almost always have an answer there so long as he doesn't overextend his Gladiator's Medallion aggressively. Pinpoiki still maintaining his mana at 12% dampening. Really 30%, 40% is where Pinpoiki needs to get to with still having more than 50% mana. If he can manage to do it, perhaps Change My Mind can pull it off.
I think there's definitely a possibility, but it's just from how we've seen it play out in the past, eventually the consistent damage from Swapsy and Raikou really overwhelms. We'll have to see what they can get done. And now a swap over onto Chaz, caught into a bash, into a cheap shot. Nicely done there by Acro, who still has his Vendetta. And Chaz could be in some trouble. He's already traded out the renewal. A second Gladiator's Maledict is going to connect, and Chaz hasn't topped himself off. Anti-magic zone's going to be traded out by Swapsy. Quickly, Method Black is burning through a lot of their defensive arsenal, and Acro's been doing such a great job in this match, consistently getting pressure on Chaz and actually getting momentum for his team.
Chaz Shadow Meld one of the Gladiator's Maledicts and then went into bear form right before being stunned. Nice plays by Chaz. They can hold on to major objective defensive cooldowns like Darkness because of that top-level play. The defense looks solid, but Pinpoiki at the same time is doing a much better job than the last time we saw these teams go head-to-head in terms of managing his mana and finding opportunities. If there was a game for Change My Mind to be able to pull it off, this is looking to be it, but now pressure onto Fried Kitty. He can't afford to just throw it away. Pinpoiki set his team up for so long. Going down without using an ice block would be so devastating. Triple crowd control initiated by Change My Mind. They're going after Raikou. They need to get a darkness. Can they put out enough damage to get a darkness? It's actually Fried Kitty that's taking more damage. They drop the Icy Veins. They really want to get the darkness, but Fried Kitty's still in trouble. Will he have to ice block on top of the iron bark? They really don't want to have to overlap that defense. They managed to hold on to the ice block. Pinpoiki still at above 50% mana, just 7% more dampening away. And then potentially they can go for a kill on Swapsy.
Yeah, Fried Kitty under fire. Still Raikou, Swapsy all over him. Kitty shot onto Chaz. Gets into bear form though. Will be able to tank through a lot of the damage Acro has available and survive. And now, although Pinpoiki's consistently been sneaking away and getting drinks, he's just having to use so much mana to keep Fried Kitty alive. Damage is just really overwhelming. Fried Kitty forced into his first ice block, and this is where things start spiraling out of control for Change My Mind.
Yeah, and Minpoike's mana still, now it's not looking too good. That is not enough mana in the tank. Two members low on health. Dampening also negatively impacts Change My Mind because Minpoike's healing is reduced. So it's not entirely their advantage. Now they can finally start targeting down Swapsy, though. They've got good crowd control on Chaz. If they can pull an Icebound Fortitude.
What?
Swapsy's under-responding. What? Really under-responding. Now Darkness as well. Big overlap. Crowd control is still coming. Change My Mind might be able to pull this off at the back of a lack of response and disrespect on the part of Method Black. Swapsy is still low on health. Triple Cyclone Chain. Smoke Bomb right at the back end of it. Still no Icebound Fortitude, Swapsy. That's the Smoke Bomb. He's going to hold on to it. Fried Kitty is low now as well. Will he have to Ice Block? that was such a good setup. I changed my mind. They've still got one more objective to get through, but they're just running out of time. Mana almost burned out now for Minpoike. Only one ice block.
Uh-oh, full blind.
Full blind. It's do or die for Change My Mind.
They need to take Swapsy down, but Fried Kitty's the one that's in trouble. We have to trade up the second ice block.
He's getting lower.
He does trade it out. I mean, Poike's mana is not looking good. Kidney shot onto Swapsy. Iron Bark connects, and I think Chaz, he bought enough time for his team. Swapsy's complete disregard for the damage Change My Mind has available. Still has the Icebound Fortitude available. Fried Kitty just getting run down. He needs to try to find some pressure, some semblance of damage, but he's just getting overwhelmed at this point in the game. 34% dampening. How is Poike going to keep him alive?
Maybe Fried Kitty holding out. Poike did his best to try and get to this point. Maybe they can kill Swapsy before they die. It's a race to the finish. Fried Kitty is stabilized, but Acro is still low. Poike quit for a drink. If he can get mana, no one's stopping him. All right, never mind. Stop now. No mana for you. Fried Kitty at least goes to full health. Swapsy's in trouble. No defense for 4 more seconds. 3 second window of time to kill Swapsy. 2 seconds, 1 second left. Now Iron Bark should deny the kill if they even need it. Fried Kitty's in trouble. That Abomination chopping him up. Grip back into the fray, and Fried Kitty will fall. Method Black once again asserting dominance.
Adaptation here. We know Valet is one of the best, obviously not a favored matchup, but will it be enough for Change My Mind to start turning this around?
We will find out here momentarily. I'm curious to see where Change My Mind decide to play it out on Mugambala. Are they going to play on the top of the balcony and look for mind controls? Are they going to play in the bottom in the open field? So far, it looks like bottom open field is where they want to fight. Not going to be getting any utility out of that mind control, but at the same time, if they fight on the top of the balcony, they stack up and they could get cleaved down. So it's a double-edged sword no matter where they decide to fight. At least down here on the bottom, it's much more similar to a Tolvaron Arena style of play. Raikou gets bursted quite hard early on. Lots of defensive cooldowns overlapped in the side of Method Black. Already this composition looks better, at least.
Way better. Raikou low, polymorph, full polymorph on Chaz. Raikou could be in some trouble. He has a reverse magic. He needs to get on top of Chaz, but he could just get taken down right here, right now. Chaz manages to get the dispel magic, and now Raikou and Chaz retreating behind the pillar. Raikou will inevitably top off in this situation, but look at this. Changed My Mind playing Shadow Priest Mage. Things are already looking way better for them.
Poike gets swapped too. Wants to potentially reposition at the top, then realizing maybe that's not the best place to fight. They're actually just draining him down. This looks pretty difficult for Minpoike so far to deal with. Getting Ursul's Vortex back in the DPS. He needs to reposition out in the open so his partners can free cast. Running up and down the stairs is not providing any benefit to his team. Now repositioning back to the far open field. They can't chase him over here, otherwise they'll overextend themselves. Valet positioned on top of Chaz. Looks like he wants to start a crowd control chain. Chaz knows that, so he jumps to his teammates and tries to escape that. Maybe they even switch to Chaz. I wouldn't mind some strategy change-ups if I change my mind. They had good pressure on Raikou early on, but really, there's no significant advantage off the back end of that first attack. Fried Kitty now on the back foot. No Iron Bark for 8 seconds. This could be an ice block if he's not careful.
Yeah, definitely. Imprisonment now on him in Poike. Once again, Raikou looking for a mana rift, finds it on him in Poike. But he did manage to sit down for a drink and reset some of his mana. I think that was one of the reasons why they decided to go with Mugambala. Such a huge map that it's going to be a lot easier for him in Poike when he can sneak away to find a location that's difficult for Raikou and Swapsy to really shut that down.
All right, let's see if they can get an ice block with this push. Not going to be able to. Instead, retreating away, waiting for the defense to fall, maybe going after Minpoike. I'm wondering if Minpoike is running the Feral Affinity. You usually see that when a Restoration Druid is playing with two spellcasters. He is not running the Feral Affinity, so it's actually surprising to see this much pressure put onto him. He is easily the worst target to kill, I would say, for Change My Mind, although Raikou would like to be attacking him to Mana Rift as frequently as possible. Let's see if Minpoike has managed to sneak away. Chaz jumps right on top of him. Not going to be finding any mana there. Still not able to see his mana bar just yet to find out if there's a lead or not. As soon as he comes out of bear form, I would say Chaz is ahead. Actually, he's even, at least. But if the healers are even, you've got a Demon Hunter and a Death Knight that are sustaining themselves. You've got a mage that isn't. If you're both at zero mana, Minpoike loses that race. So Minpoike needs a significant lead in mana to even have a shot.
Yeah, Minpoike still just getting trained down by Raikou. Imprisonment into another mana rift. Method Black been nailing them consistently onto Minpoike here, and Quickie's been struggling to keep his mana up. Swapsy, Raikou, they're all over him. Frat Kitty and Valet, they need to try to find some sort of counter pressure here. Finally, some good control. Raikou caught into a polymorph. Swapsy snared up, and Minpoike positioning on the top side of the map, going up the stairs. This is a good position for him to try to run and hide, but Chaz still just chasing him down. Whenever Raikou, this is one thing Method Black does great. This is what you want to do, is this composition. When Raikou and Swapsy are getting controlled, that's when Chaz has to tag in and be like, okay, yeah, I'll be looking after him in Poike. I'll be babysitting him, making sure he can't reset his mana, because if Method Black can consistently shut down the drinks, they will inevitably have a mana lead in this matchup.
There's an opportunity, Raikou not running the cover of darkness. But his darkness is not guaranteed survival for his team. It's actually very limited. So if Change My Mind can get a huge swing of burst damage and Method Black aren't ready for it, that could be one way for them to win. And Poike is just having such a hard time in this matchup, which is why I think him changing from Druid to Mistweaver would be at least a good short-term option. But it seems like Change My Mind, their strategy for the tournaments is to just be the best rogue mage or the best Shadow Priest mage, but both of those compositions are just being overwhelmed by this one that Method Black have brought to the competition. Valet gets bursted, Minpoike preempts the attack, but then Method Black instantly switch targets. They manage to pull two defensive cooldowns on one setup. Now Minpoike needs to be careful in the next attempt if they look to swap to him. Chaz is chasing down Minpoike. Minpoike actually just cyclones Chaz. Now that's a bit of a BM positioning on Chaz's part. The only way Method Black could really lose this, I think, is if they end up either making mistakes or getting overconfident, and they're actually showing signs of both.
Yeah, Minpoike getting asphyxiates done once again. This is going to be three mana rifts in a row on Minpoike. Look at his mana, already down to 15%. Commanding lead here by Method Black. Blade overlaps his Void Shift as well. Minpoike was in some trouble, but I think that was kind of a panic mode for Change My Mind. I don't know if they necessarily had to do that, but Minpoike wasn't feeling too healthy. And now his mana still not looking great as Raikou's just chasing him down. Swapsy running after him as well. If they can continue these setups on him in Poike, it's going to be so difficult for him to ever really drink. What are Valet and Fried Kitty going to do? Because they have to try to figure something out.
Minpoike is almost totally tapped on mana. The Mugambala curveball is just not working. Method Black are basically just toying with Change My Mind, just running down Minpoike. Really no semblance of counter pressure. Change My Mind need an absolute miracle, or they just need to throw any composition that isn't the two that they've brought to the tournament today to try and overcome this disadvantage, because right now this is easily the most one-sided matchup that I have seen. Fried Kitty and Valet trying to pump down Swapsy, but without another, 20% deafening at least, I don't think Swapsy is going to be a viable option, and neither is Raikou. And Minpoike doesn't have mana to get to that point, unlike game number one. He's been kiting back and forth, up and down the stairs, just unable to escape with both the damage over time effects from the Death Knight, the ghoul, and a demon hunter chasing you with spectral sight. You can never get into stealth. You're not going to get away. The only thing really going in favor of Change My Mind is that Chaz is feasibly low on mana. Other than that, everything is in Method Black's favor.
Run, Minpoike, run, but he gets Death Grip back into a Chaos Nova. Mana Rift will be nailed once again by Raikou, and Minpoike, look at his mana. You can't see it. It is completely tapped. A little bit of regeneration going on, but I don't know what he's going to do. There's no Void Shift available. Barskin's going to fade. Innervate, the last thing he could potentially ever do to get mana back in this game. Method Black has been unrelenting in their assault on Minpoike, and he just has not found a single moment to really breathe in this matchup. Fried Kitty and Valet, they just haven't been able to find the counter pressure. A nice little setup here onto Chaz, but Method Black, they know they're at the finish line. They drop out Darkness. They drop out the anti-magic zone. Every defensive cooldown they have to keep Chaz alive. Now Minpoike, this is the final little moments of his life.
I mean, it's just one big push. If they don't get it, then Method Black are going to take this. Minpoike's got nothing left. Raikou in hot pursuit. They can't crowd control both Swapsy and Raikou. Minpoike is on the run in desperation to try and get deeper into dampening for Swapsy to become more of a target for their composition. Just running laps, jumping to Chaz, trying to escape to safety. If anything, potentially Swapsy is overextended by trying to chase him down so much. Maybe creating some damage in multiple places would be a better option. Minpoike gets gripped, then gripped back. He's just unable to escape, trying so desperately to give his team an opportunity deeper into dampening. Chaz sees this moment and seizes the opportunity to sit down, regenerate a huge lead. So now even that feasible option. Minpoike, did you manage to sneak away?
If Minpoike sneaks away, no. This is an absolute miracle. Oh.
They don't see each other.
Stealth.
Chaz misses it. Oh, but Minpoike decides he has to heal. Fried Kitty's just under too much pressure.
I gotta say, I'm impressed with Minpoike's ability to kite and stay alive, but I think this is what Raikou and Swapsy needed to do. Minpoike's out of mana. Stop chasing the druid with Guardian Affinity. Go after someone else. Minpoike's not gonna be able to heal them up. It becomes really difficult as a restoration druid to have heal over time effects on multiple targets. So keep the pressure on Fried Kitty. Make sure Minpoike can't drink, and that really is your win condition. But look, Minpoike actually sneaks in a Hibernate onto Chaz as they make a swap onto him. I think Chaz is going to be okay. He's in bear form, has bark skin. I don't think Change My Mind really has the damage just yet to take him down, but the silence, they might prove me wrong. Safeguard procs, Fried Kitty low, second Ice Block forced out. And now Change My Mind, there's so many vulnerable targets, but if they can make one more miracle swap on Chaz, they might be able to take him down. But with the Gladiator's medallion as well as Iron Bark, I think he should be able to keep himself up.
Fried Kitty has no ice blocks remaining. Minpoike was trying to
get
mana. He
drank so much! Oh,
he got
goodness.
The mana back, but there was no defense available, and perhaps...
Region, this is just going to pad their stats unless Change My Mind can get a win in the Sands of Tolvaron.
All right, this is it. Change My Mind. Minpoike, Acro, and Fried Kitty going to be at least bringing in a different composition to combat this onslaught by Method Black. Will the Mana Rift strategy be counteracted here on Tolvaron, the biggest map in the pool? Can Minpoike escape to safety, extend the game long enough to find a kill onto Swapsy? Is Acrolol running the grapple weapon strategy? I believe that he is. Potentially, that is their last option to take down Method Black. But really, the downside for the rest of the series is that Method Black don't have to only play this composition. If they have a better option, like a Rogue Mage themselves, into this Windwalker Mage, Change My Mind might be out of options. It might be too little too late, but they're going to try and lead with their best foot forward here on match point.
Yeah, the question is, what will Acro be able to get done on that Windwalker Monk? I like that they're changing it up. I'm just not fully sold that the Windwalker Monk is going to provide enough damage, because that seems to be what they have been lacking in these games. The Assassination Rogue, known as a class that does have really good lockdown. The Kidney Shot is a really powerful ability with the damage that they have available to try to take someone down. And Raikou and Swapsy have been able to shrug it off. We'll have to see if Acro is prepared and prepped on the Windwalker Monk. So far, good damage here, rolling for Change My Mind. Raikou caught into a stun, paralysis onto Chaz. But it looks like Raikou will be able to top off and stabilize.
All right, Minpoike, can you extend the game long enough for your team to find victory? At least put one point on the board and break the curse. Method Black are just undefeated versus Change My Mind in tournament play. Good pressure on Raikou. They managed to pull Blur out from this attempt. At least something. Minpoike, though, continues to get mana rifted, and unless he is able to escape, get into stealth and regenerate mana, it's just an inevitability. Raikou gets bashed up. Good coordination with Fried Kitty as they swap over to Raikou, try and catch him off guard and burst him down. Fist of Fury flying, lots of damage. Raikou still low. Iron Bark appears to be enough now, but they've managed to at least pull the Gladiator Safeguard Absorb as well with that attempt. Change My Mind are getting good setups onto Raikou, but Minpoike is already almost tapped.
Here's one thing I've noticed is without that threat of the Shadow Step Kidney onto Raikou, he's feeling a lot more confident in this matchup to just train down Minpoike, and that's going to accelerate how fast Minpoike goes out of mana unless he can escape. He can go for a re-stealth here, sit down for a drink. Things could be looking good, but Swapsy with his ghoul control has been on point throughout basically this entire season. He's doing a really good job making sure they play into their win condition. They never allow Minpoike to sneak off for drinks, and if they can do that, they're going to be looking good in this matchup. Raikou now turning his attention onto Fried Kitty, trying to get some damage and pressure rolling. And one of the great things about the Windwalker Monk in order to assist Fried Kitty is he is going to have the Ring of Peace with that zone denial we kind of talked about. If Swapsy and Raikou have a little bit too much uptime, they could drop Ring of Peace on Fried Kitty. That allows him a little bit of room to breathe. In addition, the Tiger's Lust, another talent that the Windwalker Monk has. It's a sprint as well as a root break, so that will allow Fried Kitty to get away if Raikou and Swapsy have an extended period of time where they're on him. So those two additions in terms of defense will allow them to survive long enough, but I just feel like the lack of the single target pressure the Windwalker provides against these two classes in particular, especially the stun locks, just forces Minpoike to get trained down. Raikou's just feeling so confident running him down, getting him out of mana. This is way before dampening has even kicked in, and Minpoike is almost completely tapped.
Acrolol trying to time these grapple weapons during the eye beam of Raikou to deny the soul rending healing, the leech healing during that metamorphosis. Double leg sweep, followed up by that grapple weapon, but just simply no damage. Fried Kitty is unable to generate counter pressure, facing down Method Black here on match point. And the thing is, for Change My Mind, they do want to try and at least attempt for a second place seed so that they can avoid the best teams from North America moving to that spring final. They've been consistent and doing a great job against some of the lesser teams, but Method Black and Wildcard Gaming are just a step ahead, and it's mostly on the back of comp diversity and options. Change My Mind under fire. Minpoike almost tapped on mana. Fried Kitty in desperation here, not even into dampening just yet and struggling to stabilize.
Yeah, definitely Minpoike topping him off, but not really too much mana left to work with at this point. You can see once again the ghoul chasing down Minpoike behind the pillar. And that just is really off the back of Swapsy having excellent pet control. Chaz chasing him down as well. Now Fried Kitty getting low, might have to trade off the ice block. Minpoike looking to deny with the Iron Bark as Raikou turns his attention on to Minpoike. Another mana rift lands. And what are they going to do? What is the opening here? Raikou, he has so many defensive cooldowns. Swapsy as well. Nothing has been forced out onto Method Black. And this is not looking any better than Rogue Mage Druid.
It's looking quite grim. And Poike is unable to sneak away and find opportunities to drink. Maybe he has in this position. He's been spending at least a lot of time in cat form. Curious to see if he was able to.
I don't think they saw him.
Fried Kitty is getting bursted. An ice block for mana, though, is still a good trait. He didn't get... That's not nearly enough.
Yeah, a little bit, though.
That's not enough.
A little bit's better than nothing. Let's be optimistic here for Change My Mind. Minpoike has been running around trying to escape to get drinks, and that's really what it's going to come down to. Will Method Black choke, basically, and allow Minpoike to escape, get some drinks? Chaz chasing him across the map. Good pressure here still on the Fried Kitty. He might have to trade an ice block. Minpoike is going to have to use his Iron Bark to deny some damage, increasing his healing, and also allow him to top off Fried Kitty. Any more spam coming in. Change My Mind just trying to stay alive, allowing Minpoike to potentially get some damage off. They need a little bit more dampening in order to take down Raikou and Swapsy.
Touch of Death attempt. This is where we would typically see Method Black intimidated and taking tons of damage, but even that, Blur just exchanges one for one. Minpoike is almost totally tapped. Actually, in a Cyclone, this could be an Ice Block. Good crowd control attempt by Method Black. They're going to net themselves an Ice Block off the back of that. So even if they're not relying 100% on the Mana Rift, they've still got crowd control and burst as well to play for a win condition. Fried Kitty is still low on health, 4 seconds away from an Iron Bark. Minpoike is trying to stall it as long as he can. He did a great job healing on basically nothing on Mugambala, but even still, will they be able to overcome this adversity?
I'm just not sure. I don't know what their options are here. I mean, Raikou doesn't have Blur, and he's not playing Trinket, so they could go for a huge all-in attempt with a leg sweep into a bash from Minpoike, something like that. But I think if Swapsy backs him up, I mean, look, Swapsy's actually dropped the anti-magic zone. That's how unafraid he is in this matchup of the burst damage that Change My Mind really does have available, opting to trade out some of that defense for offense, which is something we don't normally see from him. Chaz at any point can go and sneak away for a drink. Now if Chaz gets to drink, that's just going to be a disaster for Change My Mind, because right now Chaz actually isn't doing great on mana. Now finally Change My Mind finding some pressure onto Raikou. What are they going to be able to get done? Fist of Fury coming in from Acro, grapple weapon. Raikou can't stabilize, he can't keep himself alive. Good burst damage. Minpoike sitting down for a drink, and this is the exact situation we needed to see from Change My Mind to turn this particular match around.
Good setup by Minpoike, but Fried Kitty is low. He can't afford to not block on match point. They're really relying on Iron Bark, but they're so deep into dampening, it may not be enough. Fried Kitty crowd control Swapsy. They try and burst down Raikou. We have seen Raikou make mistakes in the past and get bursted down. So there's potential for Change My Mind as they battle it out to the absolute bitter last opportunity to try and get a kill facing down the Titan Method Black. Raikou burning out the rest of that mana. Minpoike is basically healing on nothing. Acro's got one big push left. Can he get a kill with this push? Now is the question. Fried Kitty is still low. He can't counter pressure. They go for the grapple weapon. They go for the wombo combo to try and take down Swapsy, but Icebound Fortitude, fair trade by Swapsy, should be more than enough for him to stabilize and push Fried Kitty over.
Yeah, Fried Kitty in a lot of trouble here. This could be the second ice block, and it's always around 20% dampening when things start spiraling out of control. Four Change My Mind. Minpoike, no mana left. Caught into a bash. Fried Kitty forced the ice block. Iron Bark overlapped. Things are not looking good here for Change My Mind. Method Black just needs a little bit more damage. They just need to stay in it, play it calm, cool, and collected. Chaz chasing down Minpoike, not allowing him to drink. And the Fried Kitty, he's basically run out of time.
All three members in trouble as Method Black look to close this out. Fried Kitty unable to escape. Minpoike gets interrupted, and Method Black clean sweep, Change My Mind.
feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up, 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.